You may detect a slight breeze sort of sound on the microphone. You might be able to hear a slight hum. That's because it's really hot in the UK right now, and I'm not going to do anything about it. I'm not going to sit here and sweat whilst I'm doing a food review. I went to B&M, oh, move the carrier bag and getting back up again. I went to B&M Bargains, and I got a range of things. Now, there would have been two cans of moose juice here, but I drank them a couple of days after buying the stuff, and this stuff has managed to cling on a week, except for this, which I've already broken into. This peanut butter is actually pretty good. I've eaten quite a lot of it, as you can see. Anyone with a nut allergy, don't smell this. If you're from future YouTube, don't smell this. I can. I love the smell of peanut butter. Melted on toast. Amazing. Yeah, that is actually really, really good. How much was that? The Big D peanut butter was £2. It was sort of an alright price, really. What else did I get? Something I've never tried before in my life, which is shocking to people because I love bitter, sour stuff. And when I was setting up the camera, I didn't mean to look at the back, but it does say, caution. Consuming more than one piece at a time may cause irritation to mouth. The word the has escaped them again. Sensitive individuals should not consume this product. So well to that, I want to know what it's like. All good things come with a warning. Can't smell anything yet. So this is toxic waste nuclear fusion. Or as, what was it? Prime Minister Bush. Nuclear, because he couldn't say nuclear, could he? He kept saying nuclear. It's nuclear. Hazardous sour candy. Okay, then. So how do you get into this beast? So you know, it says I should only eat one piece. Ah, oh, it's in handy little. It's in nice little individual packets for ease of use. And there's five different flavours. There's a raspberry forward slash lemon. There's banana forward slash blueberry. Orange forward slash apple. Grape forward slash strawberry. And pineapple forward slash passion fruit. Now, does that mean there's two tastes going on at a time? Or what? I don't know. But I'm going to try my first hazardous waste. I love the little barrel it comes in as well. Caution, consuming more than one within a brief time may cause irritation to mouth. Sensitive individuals should not consume this product. Loads of warnings, isn't they? I can get into it. Oh, I've got the blue one. What was the blue one? Looks like Strepsils, doesn't it? What you give to someone if they've got a sore throat. Be a great April Fool's joke. What's the blue one? Banana and blueberry. Oh, there goes the eye. Oh, this is good. Oh, that is. And the inside is sweet. Well, it's a hell to the rules. It just said on the top what flavours what. I thought it was just a guessing game. I'm going to have one more. Let's see if we can tell the difference. Yeah, the inside is super sweet. But it's the outside that is surreptitiously sour. I don't know. I was trying to think of a word beginning with S. Oh, gosh. I like these. Oh, I'm really not going to swallow that. I'm just going to keep sucking this one. You know what it reminds me of? I know it's gone. No, it's gone. It goes that quick. Well, that's weird. What is that? Summer. It reminds me of when you get them Robinson's condensed, super concentrated things. Remember it ages ago, and I squirted a neat one in my mouth. Tastes just like that. It's that same sort of sour. Right. Yeah. I like toxic waste. It's mainly citric acid, I think. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, and malic acid, whatever that is. I don't know, but I've just eaten it. I'm gonna save the savouries till last. Got some VIP nuts, but I don't like to mix them savoury. I don't like going savoury sweet. Lots of people have been asking me to review these. It's Skittles Dips, yoghurty coated. Oh. Well, I need something to mellow out the mouth after eating toxic waste. Oh, look, they're all white inside. Oh, it actually smells like yoghurt in the sense of, you know when you get them yoghurt coated flapjacks? It smells like that. What an odd combination. It was the correct flavours on the back. The green one is lamb, as it's supposed to be, and not apple. Mmm. They're nice. Oh, I like them. They have quite a thick coating of yoghurt. Mmm. I like them as well. What else have we got? Pepero. Is it Pepero? Or Pepero? Don't know. What is this? This was the most weirdest found. I should say what the prices are from B&M, shouldn't I? Flexi-loop case. What was that? Don't know what I bought there. Have I been charged for something? Toxic waste was £1, and the Skittles were £1, and these white chocolate cookie sticks, it says, were 69p. What are these? It's Korea's number one brand. Is it really? I don't think I have any Korean subscribers or viewers. You'd have to let me know. Is it really Korea's number one brand? And it's made by Lotte Confectionery. And it's white chocolate coated, like fake Oreo sort of thing going on here, isn't it? That's all it says. Very little information. Is it like Mikado? No, is it Mikado? Is it Mikado? You know them biscuits that are dipped in chocolate? It is exactly like them. Oh, except more chunkier. Look at that. Ooh. Well, on the way over from Korea, they must have lost a lot of flavour. Oh, yeah. Made in Korea. Imported by Unisnacks of Welwyn Garden City. That's in England. Not a lot of flavour to these, but I can imagine these being quite you know, with some better packaging. I can imagine these being quite popular with pretentious people. Oh yes, I have a Pepero and espresso, please. That's, yeah, that's definitely what they'd have. You don't seem to get many in a box either. No, you really don't, so they would go down with pretentious people. How many have just eaten? Two. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's 10 in a box. 10. You can taste all the biscuit now of the chocolate and the cookie. No. Not. They're just not so good. Not so good. Might be Korea number one brand, but if that's the case, Korea, you need to rethink your options of who you think is your number one brand. But then again, it just says number one brand. It doesn't say what for. Number one brand for disappointment. Well, lastly but not leastly, and it's not least at all, is Oreo Enrobed. If you put a bathrobe on an Oreo, you get an Oreo Enrobed. I like saying enrobed like that. It's a daft word, but they use. It's mainly a word they only use when they're enrobing chocolate around something, isn't it? You know, if I was to dip this in chocolate, it'd be an enrobed Poundland remote. If I was to cover myself in chocolate, I would be an enrobed Charlie. I'm going to try the white ones first. These are quite heavy. They feel really substantial. Mondelez. But they'd already been opened then. I'd be like furious. Let's see what you get inside. Oh, they're individually wrapped. And I say individually, but in pairs. Up and easy enough. You can see the Oreo through the white chocolate. That's a good and a bad thing. It looks cute, but that does mean it's quite thinly and rude. I don't think these ones are from the UK, because I got them from B&M. Have been imported from mainland Europe. Chocolate fingers. You definitely need to drink these with some milk. No, I dislike Oreo immensely, not because of the bad biscuits. It's just sloshed over everything, and Oreo is just ubiquitous now. You used to have this merry time in the UK where we didn't have Oreo at all. We were happy with our increasingly superior vast array of biscuits. Digestives, the pink wafer biscuit, custard creams, bourbons, hobnobs, and penguin biscuits. Oh, there's so many biscuits. The last thing we wanted was Oreo invading us like some sort of unwanted wasp. They're alright, but the white chocolate they've coated them in, great. Very sweet. Very, quite oily, quite sweet. Probably used a lot of vegetable oil and sugar and milk powder to make it enrobed white. It's got a star on it, but I've not been able to find out what the star means. The original Oreo richly covered with a white chocolate flavour coating. So it's not white chocolate. It's white chocolate flavour coating. That's what the star probably meant. We'll try the last one, and I'm going to have a bit of a break and try the nuts. Because I've had all the sweet stuff now. what is this one? This is the just Enrobed milk chocolate flavour coating, probably. Looks a bit like something else, but I can't think what. It's bloomed a bit, look. It's got that white fluffy sort of thing on the top. Bit of a sheen. It's not good. And this one, I can barely taste the chocolate at all. In fact, I can't, I can just taste the biscuit. Another in the UK, they've just released them where they've been enrobed with Cadbury Dairy Milk. Bloody boiling. Now I know they're taking a competition between the weather stations in the UK, between ITV and the BBC. On Thursday it's going to be 35, it's going to be 36, it's going to be 37, it's going to be 38 degrees. Probably Sky News and the Daily Mail are probably saying it's going to be like 100,000 degrees or something, I don't know. And that might not be up where you are, but bloody hell is up here. I don't know why there was in B&M these ones, because you know they're going to sell more if they slosh the Cadbury over it. And I might give them a try another day. But for now, I've eaten a lot of sweet stuff. Yogurt coated, toxic waste, Pepero, Enrobed sweetness. Well, I liked them. These were just a bit flavourless. And these just are not chocolatey at all. It's just the biscuit again with pointless Cadburys that have been enrobed around it. I bet you're getting really annoyed about how I pronounce the word enrobed. Anyway, that's enough for now. I'm gonna have a glass of milk. In a couple of minutes, I'm going to try these VIP nuts. One of them is deliciously hot chili, Bollywood barbecue, and classic sea salt. Ridiculously hot. VIP nuts, the gourmet peanut. I thought it says peanut bland, but it says brand. And it's by the New York Deli.com, made in the UK. I'm going to start with the most generic sort of flavour, which is classic sea salt. It's classic. You know, whenever you look at the sea, you always think of the classic sea salt, don't you? Tear here. It did. That's sort of got a ghoulish tinge. You don't get much in, by the way, because it's only 25 g. Grams. Oh, what's it? It's coming up to 29 degrees inside the house. It's ridiculous. One. It's just nutty. Not really sea salt. I can see salt, but I just can't taste it. Maybe you should just shuck the nuts first. Alright, but can't really taste much. I'm gonna move on to Bollywood barbecue. A barbecue's a big thing in India. I don't know, I've never been. Now these have got a sort of a coating on. Yeah, they have definitely got a coating on these. Oh! Yeah, they've got a kick to them. But it's more of a... I wouldn't say that was barbecue, that's more like... more of a curry powder sort of taste. Oniony, garlicky sort of taste. I'm alright. How much did I pay for these again? Certainly for that. I'll tell you in a minute. And these ones are rot chilli, which is the most ridiculous thing to eat on an hot day like this. You know? It's mainly a mum and a grandma thing to say, isn't it? It's either your mum or your grandma that say, the best thing you can have on a hot day is a cup of tea. No, it is not. Sweaty bit like me, but he's sweating even more. No. Gosh, these smell strong. Oh, gosh. We've definitely got coating on. These are definitely going to be spicier than the Bollywood barbecue ones. Making my tongue tingle. Yep. Spicy-ish, yeah. Oh gosh, yeah, after Ben. Yeah, after Ben. How much was these anyway? Let me have a look. Put the tonic water on top of it. I'm drinking tonic water. Schweppes. Oh, I love tonic water. I like the word Schweppes as well. It's so refreshing, isn't it? Schweppes. The nuts were 39p each. So there you go. Anyway, that was my B&M stuff. There you go. It was from the B&M in Hull. That would have normally been next door to Toys R Us! That's the saying used to go. Anyway, I'm sorry it's been so subdued, but I'm just so blooming boiling hot. Oh, it's so hot. It's ridiculous. And this isn't even the hottest day yet. It's only Tuesday. You've got 2 days to go yet. I may have melted. Oh well, up until then. Scrass and Bellamy. Bye.